I have matters in court. I went to court in 2011. I was not happy with the outcome. Similar thing that happened in 2011 was what happened in 2015, where a pre-election matter was adjourned indefinitely after the election.
Okay, let's get back to this.
It happened to me.
Let's get back to the budget.
And it just happened.
I'm looking at that time now.
So what's your story? Just happened to the Michael Sogomi case of the nomination of General Buhari. So what are you saying?
About the economy and what we need to do to put it back on track, does it mean then, in the light of your analysis of the budget and what's going on with the economy, that nothing good whatsoever about the budget?
Well, I won't say absolutely nothing good, but I will say in totality, that budget can only lead to ruination. And I mean it.
Talk about it in terms of employment and the social protection program that the government has.
Well, the social protection program, I do not accept. Because when you have multiple programs, you must prioritize. These are standard management practices all over the world, in Asia, in the US, in Africa. Anybody who knows what he's doing, when you determine all your objectives, you have a hierarchy of objectives. That's your prioritization.
How should they approach that one?
Now, in this particular case, you remember what I said? You don't take it out of context. The direction is critical. Now, once you have that direction, your strategy, in other words, your strategy is the philosophy of your plan. What did we say, for example? We said critical to economic development was power. We said we prioritize power. And we said that over the 4 years tenure, we will take out $9 billion to double power. We were clear about that. Because that was a high-level priority for us. Now, we're now saying that this particular budget you have referenced has a $38 per barrel benchmark price, which, in my personal opinion, is not conservative enough. I'm not saying it's wrong.
What should it have been?
It's not conservative enough. It should have been...
What would conservative?
In my personal opinion. You know, it's not a one-man thing. It's a team thing. But in my personal opinion, it should be less than 35.
Even though at that time it was higher than $40.
You see what happens? What happens is, if your salary is $500,000 a month, government takes away 20%, you have 400,000. If in your mindset, at the end of every month, I have $500,000 to spend, and you go on a spending spree and spend $500,000, you don't have it. So I'm talking about being conservative. And that also helps your fiscal discipline. Now, if you get an extra, if it turns out that the average price of oil at the end of 2016 is $60 per barrel, you have that margin, you don't lose it. Now, you can deploy it in 2017. But now, you already put yourself in a position where you're on a cliff. And where if you slide, you break your back.
Okay, so...
So you don't put yourself in that kind of a position. So this particular budget, the major problem we have with this budget is that it is logically and intellectually contradictory.
But you were supposed to talk about the social protection program and the strategy, which is the philosophy.
The social protection program is also a contradiction, because what is your primary emphasis? Is it playing to the gallery? Is it cheap populism?
Empowering the unemployed.
No, you don't empower them with 5,000. Don't forget the what do you people call it? The allegory of teaching to fish and giving a fish. Your own teachers that are threatening to go on strike, you want to give a meal, pay the teacher first. That's my thinking. Maybe your thinking is different. Give the gala to the students and owe the teacher. And maybe that's how you get a good education. I don't know. Secondly.
So you mean they should scrap that program? Is that what you're saying?
If you can fund it, good. But to take out 500 billion and say it's for a wasteful venture of giving gala to or whatever snack to children.
You think it's wasteful?
Very wasteful. You know why? If you paid Chamberlain, he will feed his child to go to school. And if you paid the teacher will teach the child that you achieve your objective. Don't forget, like I said, you must be clear about your objective. What is our objective? Is it cheap popularity?
But the thing about it is that, I mean, will any unemployed graduate be happy to receive handouts? So it's not that,
Let me tell you, as I am here, if the government gives me a handout, I will take.
Even though you think
it's... And I'm a millionaire. If the government gives me a handout, 5,000, I'll take it. You think I will throw it away? If I take it, I could even give it out to a poor person. But I'm going to take it if government gives it. What do you mean? Government will give me a handout, I'll reject. Why?
Okay,
let's get these things clear. You see, my problem with some of our people is we want the right result, but we deliberately and consistently do what is wrong. And that's why we have been getting the wrong answers for nearly over 50 years. The only way you get the right answers is do the right things. Journalists do the right things. Politicians do the right things. Engineers do the right things. Teachers do the right. We need to do the right things. We need to do them consistently.
What kind of fiscal policy would you put in place given what we're faced with today?
Well, it's very simple. Once a leadership is in place, whether legitimate or illegitimate, once a leadership is in place, it must exercise its authority. And when you're talking about fiscal policy, you see, my own emphasis is not the policy. My emphasis is the philosophy. Now, if you have fiscal discipline, for example, the waste that we all know about, we will not have.
But what's the philosophy without the policy?
The philosophy dictates the policy. The philosophy is the wisdom, is the logic, is the philosophy means love of knowledge. It's the OJ of the policy. I need to have that very right. So if you have it very right, you find other things fall in line. For example, if you come to a federal executive meeting and you said, we need to achieve this. Of all this, this is key. Before I leave this office, this needs to get done. Let's do what we need to do to get it done. Mr. Chamberlain, next meeting, let us know what we need to do to get it done. Let me know what I need to do. Let Suleiman know what he needs to do. Let Mugwe know what she needs to do. Next meeting, you come with that, we review and we approve. Everybody's thinking in that direction. Everyone is working in that direction.
So you're not seeing any of those kinds of directions in this government, is that
what
you're
saying? I have just heard now is Tanko Yakasai saying that the government has no plan for power and you're just budgeting $433 billion.
Do you believe that?
No, I heard him.
Yeah, but you're quoting it. That means you subscribe to it.
No, I'm not going to stop my ears to information. I heard him. Now, yesterday, I heard the Minister for Power during his visit to the Benue plant.
Yeah, we actually had that.
Saying they will decide. You have not decided. So he was collaborating what Tanko Yakasai said. So it's not about what I believe.
Excuse me, I think
please, if you play it, it will be helpful.
No, but before we do that, I think it's also important, I mean, to also say that there was the initial plan. I mean, when he first of all came on board, there was the press briefing he had talking about the state where we are currently, talking about roads, talking about power, and talking about, what's the third ministry now? Works and housing, and what their plan is for those three ministries. Did you see that plan by any chance?
Yes, I did.
What did you make of it?
What I made of it is that it's an extortionist plan. A plan to increase power, a plan to put toll roads is extortionist.
But you actually agree.
It's extortionist. That's what I saw.
Just a moment. You agree that it is a plan. So when you say that, you know, Mr. Tanko Yakasai says that there is no plan, and then you're quoting the minister, I think it's very important that we play that particular track.
No, it's very important.
When you say that, there's no plan, I think it's very important for us to put things in context.
No, don't put words in my mouth.
Mr. Onovo.
I'm sure your viewers are listening clearly. They heard what I said. Don't tell me what I said. I know what I said. Now, I said, Tanko Yakasai said this. And then I saw on the news, the minister saying, we will decide this. To me, the decision should have been made. We should have been in implementation. How many more weeks you're going to be 1 year of the government?
But if you find
excuses for failure, we're going to continue to fail. What we need in this country is power. Brazil, over 200 million people, over 100,000 megawatts. Nigeria, 200 million people, 4,000 megawatts. And you celebrate. Excuse me.
You know, but
I will not celebrate.
But you know,
I know the situation.
But there are people who get the impression that, having listened to what you've said about some of these ministries, it's as though the ministers just sitting down there, dilly-dallying, not taking the decision as they ought to. Is that what you're implying?
No. I thank you for this clarification. What I'm implying is that some of these things are happening late. That's what I'm implying, and that's what I'm saying. And remember, at the beginning, I talked about the medium-term economic framework recommends that you present your budget proposal in August. You presented in January. You don't see anything wrong with that? Sorry. Do I see something fundamentally wrong? Yes. If you lose four, how many months from August to January? September, October, November, December, January. You lose 5 months
I think they presented
on your schedule.
They presented in December, Mr. Onovo.
When you represent, you start again.
Just
now.
A moment. They did not represent. They
when you represent,
wrote,
you start again.
They wrote
now.
A letter correcting certain parts of the budget. I think it's very important. For
were
us
you in this country when you heard about missing budget and switching budget and missing budget?
It's very important for us.
The headlines.
It's very important for us to put things in context. And I think that was also clarified when they said that the president presented a budget and they're going to work with the budget that the president presented.
No.
I think. Oh yes.
No.
The
no,
Senate
no,
president
because
said
that. Has also changed.
I'm not.
They say they're working on the new edition.
Novo. I'm telling you what I know.
No, I'm telling what you what reported. You reported.
Yes.
As a journalist, I'm telling
and
you that
I'm
you reported
you,
that they work on the new version.
Just a moment. I think it's very important to also tell you that the Senate president. We have on track. We have that on tape.
And I will show you where it was reported that the Senate will now look at the new version.
Okay, well, we will take a break now, but we'll be back and look at some of those clips that is in contention now. Don't go away yet. All that we heard, the part where he said the additional transformers that they need will be provided for in the 2017
yes,
budget.
Yes, we heard that.
That's the additional one.
Yes,
so that, it means
that's
that
one
the
decision
current
taking.
One mm-hmm. It's already been provided
no,
for
that,
while that consultation continues.
No, you didn't listen carefully.
What did he say?
In fact, he just repeated what I said here.
Which is?
He said, we're making the assessments, then we'll make the decisions. Which is correct.
So what does that mean for you?
I didn't hear him say that we'll make the assessment and we're making the
decisions. Did you expect me to repeat verbatim what he said? You
I
didn't listen. He was very clear what he said.
No, no, I think it's very important to keep things in
we
context because the meaning I got from
clips
that.
And you said something different, we go back to clips.
What he said? I didn't think you would also contest what he said.
It's really amazing. Honestly, it's been an amazing morning.
I didn't think you would contest what everybody had.
He's been an amazing boy.
Because you're the only one that seems to hear what you heard. Because I didn't hear that.
No,
he didn't hear that.
No, you didn't want to hear that clearly.
You just said he didn't listen carefully.
No, I said you didn't listen.
No, you told Chamberlain
that
he didn't listen carefully.
You clearly didn't listen carefully.
I'm sorry. If you're the only one listening carefully, then we all have to check our ears.
No, you watch it again when we leave.
Okay, but bottom line, what you're saying is that they need to do much more than they're doing. Period, isn't it?
I'm saying a lot more than that. I'm saying that directionally they have it wrong. I'm saying that intellectually they have it wrong. I'm saying that morally they have it wrong.
Are you right? Pained you lost the election? Let's get that from
I expect that from somebody like you. But did I lose an election?
I don't think it's very important. It's important for us to be personal,
okay.
Mr. Onovo.
Yeah,
because
it wasn't personal
to
say, are you
question.
Pained because you lost the election? That's not personal.
Your views are very personal, as it were.
All right, guys, we have to wrap up.
My views are... You didn't
but
see all the age voters?
We thank
never
you for
mind.
Your views.
You didn't
Martin.
See the Kano results?
Guys, you need to go. Mr.
You
Martin
didn't
Novo.
See the Borno results?
Mr. Novo, we got to go. Thank you for your time.
Thank
Mr.
You
Martin
Novo
is a former presidential candidate of the NCP, and what a session we had with him. But we'll be back in a minute. We'll have another session coming up. I don't know if it will be like this one. Don't go away yet.